finally got that bait I've been looking for. Yeah, in she goes. Filled it up. Push that back. Push off and away from there. And tie this puppy off and I'm good to go. Although I would like to get about three or four more of those. Uh-oh. Fish on. Fish on. Feels a little bit bigger than the last one, though.
When you get into a school of white perch, they'll bite anything hanging in the water.
Yeah, that's too big. That's damn near, that's a keeper-sized perch right there. Oh. Got him. Fish on. Yep, that's what we're looking for. That's the size we're looking for. Got him.
If I don't have to buy live bait, if I can catch my own, I will.
Might be a little bit too big again, though. Yeah, it's a little bit on the big side. I don't know. Nah, she'll do. That's about as big as I want to use, though. These fish are starting to make me think about perch fishing. Getting some good-sized perch here. When I'm looking for the little ones. Gotcha.
I've caught some very nice perch here before. Up around 13 inches or so.
You will have to do, as I'm ready to go striper fishing.
Yeah, it's time.
There
I can
we
only
go.
Keep myself perch fishing
fish
for so long.
Fish on. Doesn't feel all that big though. Nah, it feels like a small one. I think. Yeah, it's a little one. I mean, not that small, but not big either. It is nice to have a fish, though. That's the first strike I've had all day that I can confirm as a striper. Wow, look at all the leeches on you, buddy. That's not a good sign. Not a good sign. There we go.
Yes, these 4-inch galt swimming mullets, kind of an electric chicken color, dynamite today.
Now, let me help you out. Let's get some of these little f***ers off of you, okay? Ugh, everywhere.
If I can help out a fish
everywhere, bud.
After I've caught them, I always make sure to try to.
Boy, I do not like parasites. Oh, I think I just had a bite on my white perch line. So you just made it real quick.
I love hearing that drag sing. When I'm bait fishing. I love hearing that drag go.
Yep, still got some more up here. Let me just grab it with my hand. I hate to do that, but I gotta help you out. Oh crap. I think there's a striper on this one. Yep. Got her! Oh, I got her! Oh, this is a better fish. It's a better fish on this rod. Oh, I just got one on the white perch. Got one on the white perch. It's a little better fish. Yeah, it's a little better fish. Ooh, that's a keeper. That's a keeper fish if I can land her. Let's put this here. Put this rod over here.
Don't worry about the one fishing
the
boat.
Oh, wow.
She ends up being completely fine. Just cleaned her up and she gets released.
Yeah, if I can land her, that's a keeper here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what we're looking for. That's more like it. All right. Woo! Yeah! I tell you what, came to the right spot.
Yeah, I love it when a plan comes together.
Oh, oh! No! Oh! I wanted to get a picture of the small one. Oh well.
I'm just glad you swam off well.
I still have the one that counts. Let's get your measurement first. Because you're actually a little bit smaller than I thought. So I gotta make absolutely sure that you are in fact 20 inches. Let's see. From tip to tip. Yes, you're 20. But make sure one more way.
Here comes the lesson learned. Watch this one.
You know, you can try that if you want, but you're on the hook and... Oh, Jesus, not my rod. Not my rod. Thank you. Woo!
Lock in those rods, man.
Gonna be cleaning that reel later. Thanks to you, guy.
Gotta lock in those rods.
Now, let's try this again. She is at the end and up at 21. Yep. Okay. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna have to cut and bleed you. I'm sorry about that. It's the only way I'm gonna get this fish out of you. So, let's get your picture real quick.
Essentially, what happens is the dorsal spines of the white perch.
And I'm gonna cut and bleed you.
Make it almost impossible to get out.
Hey, what's up, cutie?
Yeah.
What?
She always has good timing here.
I'm trying to get this fish off the hook. There we go.
Yep, on to the next one.
Striper on. Doesn't feel enormous, though.
They were schooled up pretty thick behind this big bridge pilot.
Does not feel enormous. There she is. How you ate that big perch is beyond me, man. You greedy thing, you. She is at the end, all the way up to... I think she's just shy. I think she's about 19 and a half inches. But getting this fish out is not going to be easy. That's the only problem with using live bait like this. These striper, man, they're not playing around. They get a white perch, they want to swallow it. All right, the hook's out.
Yeah, a nice little fish, healthy, but just about a half an inch shy. But man, those stripers are greedy.
You
get some small fish that'll choke a big bait.
Fish on. And right now, it's feeling like my second keeper. Yeah. Feels like a pretty good one. Not a monster, but definitely a good one. Definitely feels like a keeper fish. Now I'm under my other line. So if I can grab the other line, that would be fantastic.
The perils of running multiple rods.
Yes, okay, good. Aha. Not gonna lie, I like catching them on the ultralight, man. A 20-some inch striper feels a lot better on the light tackle than it does on my big rig. And she feels like a keeper. We'll find out in a minute, but she definitely feels like a keeper. But for those interested, I'm only using about a quarter ounce jig head, which probably sounds crazy to most people who fish water with this amount of tide current, but I let it drop all the way down. Sometimes they pick it up on the fall, sometimes they pick it up when I start jigging. This one picked it up when I started jigging, but I let it fall for a good probably 30 seconds or so. Nice fish. Oh man, definitely the fish of the day thus far right here. Yes, look at that, will ya? Come on, that's it. That's her. That is keeper number two, without a doubt. Without a doubt. Lock that puppy in. Close the bail. Get this paddle back in some kind of order. All right. Hell yeah. Now, were I catch and release fishing, that'd be just about a perfect hook job right there. That's about a 22-inch fish or so. Very, very nice. Very healthy. Now, when you're taking out jig heads like this, I highly recommend some forceps, because if you try to put all the pressure from the head, you can bend the wire on that hook. Now, let's see if I can get her onto the stringer without losing her. Definitely excellent table fare right here.
She was actually closer to about 23, 24 inches.
Here's a little tip for you right here. When you're looking at the water, the way the current's coming in, when you get corners like this, it's a great ambush place and a great current break. And where I just caught that last fish, so I just drop it down here, open the bail, and let it run. Now once I do that, I'll let it drop for a good 20 or 30 seconds, again, because I'm using a quarter ounce jig head. If you have a heavier jig head, you can probably go ahead and let it drop only for a few seconds, however long it takes to get to the bottom. That's the bottom line, is when you get it to the bottom. Once you do, Reel it up, give it some pops. You're just jigging. Now these striper today are holding deep. They're not always holding deep. Today they happen to be, so I let it go all the way to the bottom. And I try to jig it with minimal reeling, because I'm not trying to reel it in. What I'm trying to do is keep it in that strike zone, because that's where those fish will sit. Those stripers love areas like this, love them. I just turned the camera off. I did exactly what I said I was gonna do. A few jig heads, a few strokes off the bottom, a few jerks, and there's a fish on. Now it's definitely smaller than the last one. I'm gonna guess and say probably about a 15 or 16 incher. Maybe pushing 17, maybe. But, I mean, the fish are right where I said they would be. They're hanging out down there. They are, uh-oh. I think this fish just wrapped itself in my other line. Either that or I just had a hit, one of the two. I might have had a hit on the perch. But like I said, about a 15 incher. Called that pretty well. Let me see if I can get some of these worms off you, buddy. I'm trying to get some of these parasites off you. I promise that's all I'm doing. It looks like I already did handling him. He had a worm or two on his side. I don't see them now. Nor do I see any on his other fins. Oh, shoot. Fish on. Fish on. Got her. Yep, I got her. Now, I was fishing this white perch on the bottom. When I do that, after I let out a lot of line to make sure it's down there, I set the drag very light. By setting the drag very light, what that does is it lets the fish run and not feel any pressure. It decreases the chance of him dropping it because he feels pressure. Feels like a decent fish, by no means huge, which is really ironic because, I mean, the white perch I'm using on here is enormous. I mean, it's freaking enormous. The white perch, I say enormous, it's enormous by my standards. The white perch I'm using on here was about 6 inches, maybe 7. Ugh. But I'm still catching, you know, 20, 21 inch striper on it. Look at him. Look what he had to go through to get that fish in his mouth, man. I tell you,
some greedy, hungry fish, man. Just choking these big white perch.
Look at him. You greedy thing, you. I don't know how you fit that fish in there. All right, let's see what I can do for you. It's going to be a pain again, that's for sure. There we go. The hook is out. The line actually broke. That's interesting. So, let's do this. You know, I might just let you keep that, buddy. Go ahead. Yeah, you go ahead. Go on. There we go. Although I would have liked to get his picture, but oh well. Fish on. Fish on. Feels pretty good. If I need another keeper, I think this would be one. But I do not. Yeah, it's a good fish. It's a good fish. Yeah. Boy, this is some good fishing, man. What a time. Oh, beautiful day. Hardly any wind. Very few waves. Low boat traffic. Oh, and nice size striper like that. I should net you, but I'm gonna see if I can thumb you. Now, for those fishermen up there in New York and Jersey, places like that, I'm sure y'all look at fish like this and be like, what, it's a dink. And I'm not saying it's big, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying it's a big striper. I'm just saying it's fun to catch. I love catching fish like this. To each his own, I suppose, and I have to say, size is largely relative to the region in which you're fishing. Down here in Maryland, the minimum size for a striper is 20 inches. I'm not sure what it is up there.
I think New York and New Jersey is up around 28 inches minimum. They have a larger size class fish.
But I'd venture a guess and say it's probably higher. let's get back over there. All right, I've went ahead, let it go down to the bottom. It's time to start jigging. Fish on. Oh, he got off. Oh, I don't know how I lost him. Oh, the lure came back around and hooked itself. No. No, lure, how could you? Fish on. Fish on. Uh-oh. She had me around the corner for a minute there. It feels like a pretty good fish. Certainly not. Oh, yeah. That's a really nice stripe. That's a really nice stripe.
Yeah, they were stacked thick down at the bottom off that corner. Very thick.
Oh no. My net has caught a back part of my kayak. I don't think it's going to reach far enough now. So let's see if I can bring her around over to this side and get her that way. Yeah, nice stripe. There she is. Oh. 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 I'm trying to keep her from getting tangled up in the line, but man, she's working hard at it. Yep, that's it. Nope, nope, not that way. There. Oh, yeah. That's the fish of the day, I think, actually. There's a nice fish. There's a nice, beautiful fish. Nice and healthy. Holy crap. She swallowed it so far, I can't even see the jig head. Oh, there it is. Come on, girl. Let's get this out of you. Let's get this thing out of you. We're going to try our best. I do not want to send you away with a belly full of lead. Nor do I want to lose my hook, to be honest, but I don't want to send you away with a belly full of lead.
Now, luckily, I was able to extract that and send her on her way.
Fish on. Fish on. Feels good. Feels like a decent fish.
And a lot of them came on the water,
getting smaller.
Which I love.
Getting smaller.
Yeah, this one shrinks as I reel her in.
It's not a bad fish, but it's not a big one either. It could be a keeper, but if she is, she is right on the line. She'd be one of those like 20-inch keepers, put it that way. Yeah. God, I live for days like these. There she is. Yeah, I think she's about an 18-incher. No, 17. Like I said, she's getting smaller. She's getting smaller. Come on, gorgeous. Come on, gorgeous. Pretty little fish. There you go. There's another shot of her. Parasite free. Good for you, girl. Well, had a great day on the water. And in total, I probably caught about 10 maybe? 10 stripers? Smallest one, probably about 15. Biggest one, 22, 23. But slack tide has arrived. And I have responsibilities to get to, so I guess the last note, best luck jigging the pylons with the curly tail grubs, the salmon mullets. Other than that, it's time to go. Have a good one.
So here's the full catch for the day, or at least the three best. But yeah, that electric chicken pattern, they call it a different name for gull, but it's essentially what you're dealing with, is that chartreuse and pink. Ooh, boy, they were loving it today. Jigging off the bottom. But yeah, questions, thoughts, comments, let me know. Thanks for watching.